Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Textbook. In this video, I am going to explain how to write an algorithm to merge two sorted array into third array, and that third array will be automatically arranged in sorted array. Right? So first, let me draw two arrays. Let's say A1, A2. So it is having four elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. Second array is A2. It is having 2, 4, 6, 8, right? And we need to create third array. And it will be having all 8 elements, right? So A1, A2 both are already in sorted form. And we need to write algorithm in such a way so that if we merge both the arrays, so third array will be automatically sorted. So now I am going to write the algorithm for you. So name of algorithm is merge. It will be having three parameters, A1, A2, A3 as 1D arrays, and two parameters as N1, N2. So N1 and N2 are size of first array and second array. So N1 is the size of A1, N2 is the size of A2. Now, I am going to write step number 1. So here I am writing set I equals to 1, j equals to 1, and k equals to 1. So I will be for A1, j will be for A2, and k will be for A3 to maintain their position number. So as you know, in algorithm, the first element index is considered as 1, so that's why all the variables are initialized with 1. Now, in step number 2, I'm going to write the steps. So here, one loop will be implemented, and that will be repeating step number 3 and 4 while, right? So 3 and 4th step will be repeated while I less than equals to N1 and j less than equals to n2. So if both I and j, I is less than equals to n1 and j is less than equals to n2, if both are true, then only this loop will be repeated. Now step number 3. So here we need to write if condition, if a1 of I. So we are going to compare a1 of I with a2 of j. So if a1 of I is less than a2 of j, then we need to perform this operation. So here more than one operation will be there. So that's why I am writing AB. So set A3 of k. So we are going to assign value to A3 array on k position, and that will be a1 of I. So the value which is lesser will be assigned into A3 because we want this third array should be in sorted form. And in B step, you can write set I equals to I plus 1. So I am incrementing value of I so that it will be positioning the next element of A1. Right? Now, if this condition is false, it means A1 of I is not less than A2 of j. So in else part, you can write set A3 of k equals to A2 of j. And here in B step, you can write set j equals to j plus 1. Right? So if first part is executed, then I will be implemented. If second part is executed, then j will be implemented. And whatever will be the case, in both the cases, after having value assigned on this position A3 of k, we need to increase k as well. So k equals to k plus 1. So this is the common step. So if condition is true, then also k will be incremented by 1. If condition is false, then also k will be incremented by 1. Right? And here, I I am writing end of loop. So this loop will be terminated, right? So now let's iterate this part of algorithm. So this is not complete right now. So I am applying this on these arrays so that we can see what happens. So n1, n2. So let's say n1 is 4, n2 is also 4. Then we have i1. For this we have j as 1. For this we have k as 1. So check this condition. Both are true right now. So a of I is less than a2 of j. So here 1 and here 2. So condition is true. So a1 position value will be assigned into a3. So 1 will shift here. Then I will be incremented. So I is 2. Then k will be incremented. So k will be 2. But j will remain 1. Again check these conditions. So still they are true. A1 of I. So a1 of I is 2 now. Is less than a2 of j. So false. So this time a2 of j will be shifted to a3 of k. So this 2 will be shifted here on 2 index and j will be incremented, then k will be incremented. So k is on 3 position, j is on 2 position and I is also on 2 position. Then again check these conditions, both are true. Then a1 of I is 2, a2 of j is 4. So again you can see condition is true. So 2 will be shifted here, I will be incremented and k will be incremented. Then again check these conditions. So both are true. A1 of I, 3. 3 position is having 3. A2 of j, j is 2. So 2 position is 4. So again this condition is true. So from here 3 will be shifted here. And I will be 4 and k will be 5. So again right now these 2 conditions are true. Check these. A1 of I, so A1 of 4, so 4 is having 4 and A2 of J is also having 4, so this condition is false now. So this time A2 value 4 will be shifted here, J is 3 and K is 6. Again these conditions are true. A1 of I, that is 4, A2 of J, it is now 6. So this time this condition is true, so 4 will be shifted here. And I will be incremented to 5, k will be incremented to 7, right? Now these two conditions are not true because I is 5, which is greater than n1. So this condition is false, so that's why this loop will be terminated. And you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 from this area copied, 2 or 4 are copied, but 6 and 8 are remaining in this array as it is. So now what we need to do, we need to check whether j is equals to n2 or I is equals to n1. So this may be scenario that we have some values available in first array as well. So second array is copied completely, but first array is having some values as left. So now after completion of this loop, we need to apply two separate loops so that we can copy the remaining elements of a particular array. So for this, I am writing step number 5, repeat steps. So it will be repeating the steps. So now step number 6 and 7 will be repeated while. So here I need to implement the condition, right? So while I less than equals to n1. So if I is still less than equals to n1, then this loop will repeat. So this time you can see I is 5 and n1 is 4. So this will be false. So this loop will not repeat in this case. But in any other case, that wherever a1 will be having remaining values, then this loop will repeat. So here what we need to do in step number 6, we need to copy a3 of k equals to a1 of I. So the remaining values of a1 of I will be copied into a3 of k, right? And then in step number 7, you can write set I equals to I plus 1 and k equals to k plus 1. And then you can write end of loop. So both I and k will be implemented, and the remaining values of a1 will be copied into a2. So this is for a1. Now same steps we need to write for a2 as well, right? So that is the case right now. So all the values remaining, that is 6 and 8, will be copied as it is here with that loop. So now I'm going to write that loop. So let me erase these. So step number 8 will be repeat steps 9 and 10 while j less than equals to n2. So this time j is on this position. So j is less than equals to n2. So we need to repeat step number 9. So here you need to write step a3 of a equals to a2 of j. So the values of a2 array will be copied to a3. Then set k equals to k plus 1 and j equals to j plus 1, right? And then you can write end of loop. So this loop will be terminated, and in step number 11 you can write end so that your algorithm will be terminated. So this loop will copy remaining elements of a1 if they are. This loop will copy remaining elements of a2 into a3 if they are. So in every time, whenever you will be executing this algorithm, either a2 will be having remaining elements or a1 will be having remaining elements. There will not be any case like both the arrays a1 and a2 are having remaining elements. So this will not be a scenario. So maybe this will execute or maybe this will execute. So this way I explain to you how you can write algorithm so that we can merge two sorted array into third array, and here you can see third array is in sorted form. So if we copy these elements as well with this loop, so as this is already in sorted form, so those sorted values will be available here. So you can see this third array is completely sorted in order. So this way I hope you understood how we can merge two sorted arrays into third array, back to in sorted order. And if you want to watch its this algorithm's implementation with C language, so in the description you can find link of that playlist, and at the end of this video you can find links so that you can learn how we can implement merging using C language. So thank you for watching this video.